Welcome to this week in SoundPoint.
Do we want this back here? I feel like this pillow is...
The bicycle pillow?
It's like on SoundPoint, we are sleepy. Alright. Hello, everybody.
Tripping fucking balls.
Alright, the question is, should I have a mug like you that looks sophisticated, or have this gigantic glass that
look
like a third grader?
You're like,
two heads.
I'm ready. Hello, people. Hi, welcome to SoundPoint. I'm Dane.
And I'm Eric.
And we're going to be reviewing a new album that has come out.
We're going to start listening to the album Gossamer by Passion Pit.
Let me turn my phone off. Well, not off, but off. Sound.
You should text that girl a picture of your penis.
But we're filming.
Yeah.
Right now?
I think they'd like to see it too.
All right.
Oh, dude, please. Please don't, dude.
Hold on, let's make sure it's in frame here.
Oh, God. Oh, it's horrific. Oh, jeez.
Don't worry. She has received it. I have not heard back.
I can't believe she hasn't responded yet.
It's a glistening piece of junk, you know?
Yeah. Well, maybe she's just awestruck.
I'm going to say junk about it. So how we do our point system is we do these things called sound points. Each song has between 0 and 1 point. Each track gets its own point. Bringing up my app to make sure that we can write these down. Oh wait, I think I just took a picture of myself. No, I didn't. I'm not that stupid. This first track is called Take a Walk.
I think this is a great way to start an album. You start with these organs building to a really catchy verse.
Yeah, because an album usually wants to start big and flashy.
The lyrics are very topical, highly politically charged. I think that's a great idea. I mean, they're out to make statement.
Exactly. So. Well, this one was definitely heavy organ.
Yeah.
Heavy organ. That was basically the crux of the melody, you know, the ba-da-da-da-da-da-da, which is a really catchy melody.
I think they're really setting us up for the rest of the album, what we do expect from instrumentation. Pretty much catchy hooks on a synthesizer, backing from the rest of the band. Okay. A little bit of dance from the drums. Yeah, a driving 2-4 beat.
Yeah, when there was background vocals, especially during the I Take a Walk part, you couldn't really hear it when the main singer was singing.
Yeah.
He said, I took a walk, and then the other singers came in with, I took a walk, then you heard that. Usually when you have some harmony to a melody line,
yeah,
then you kind of want to hear that too. Yeah, I mean, which is fine, and they definitely did add a lot, especially like the driving, like, I take a walk, take a walk. Yeah. It kind of almost made you feel like, you know, just kind of like the driving force of walking.
Yeah, I think that's why they picked the tempo they did. The tempo is really a walking speed tempo, but if you were walking around with this in your headphones, you would walk at this pace. So as an opening, I think it scores a perfect 1.9 or 1.
I would say probably 0.9.
All right. So 0.9 points so far.
You might remember this track from that Taco Bell commercial for the Locos Crazy Taco.
Yeah, thing. I mean, it's perfect. It's a song about a middle-class family who's losing all his money. And all that can afford is Taco Bell.
Exactly. And then they die horrible gastrointestinal deaths.
Well, I think that was Passion Pit's original message. I mean, this song will drive you to eat Taco Bell.
All the poor families, they basically... God damn it, that goddamn phone. I thought I turned it off, ladies and gentlemen. Apparently it's on super loud vibrate mode. Seriously, it's not even in the room. It's in the other room. It just vibrated the entire kitchen.
The walls are like... Oh, yeah, 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 yeah.
Entire room is just bowing in and out.
The next track we will be listening to on Passion Pit's Gossamer is I'll Be Alright.
Really short nose hairs. I took them hairs. Your 3 years are clean. No wax or anything. I clean every day. And then do the little like area here.
Uh-huh.
The outer pinna. Yeah, I know what it's called.
So this song, Dane, what did you think?
Let's start with... titled I'll Be All Crazy.
What did you think about the instrumentation in this one?
Oh, there's a lot of strange things going on in this one.
You get that weird little squirrel voice. The disjointedness. The disjointedness of the track reflects his lyric.
Did you want to elaborate more on the lyrics then?
I don't think they are quite to the level of the first song. I think the first song had a clear message, a clear story. This is just kind of your generic random lyrics about being depressed and or working problems out. You know, that kind of stuff. Somewhat unique. They can't just be, I'll be all right. Because a lot of people, you know, talk about being all right. What does that mean? Yeah. But then again, I guess it's relatedness. It's like, that's the kind of song you want to sing after you get like broken up with or something. I don't think
be all right. More contraction in there.
I think he's meant to make you feel pretty bad.
Done.
Give me this.
You don't want me to play with that? I want all four of them together. Yeah, that one was definitely more crazy than the first one. This is like your cat's over there.
But I think the backup vocals were also interesting. They definitely were more prevalent in this one. More of the harmonies and a lot more exciting in the background. And the reason I bring it up is because so many more bands these days are going towards really heavy vocals or really heavy harmonies.
It's kind of nice to hear a harmony where you could almost just sing that as a melody. Yeah.
The chorus on this song wasn't that exciting. I think it's weird. The verse and the like drum breakdown were interesting, and the chorus was actually the most lacking part.
The rest of the song almost feels like a completely different song.
Yeah, and all the really interesting parts are completely gone, and all the instrumentation is the one thing, quarter notes.
Ding, 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 ding. One of my favorite parts of this song has to be the breakdown. Because it was definitely different than everything else. Highly contrastive, if that's a word.
A score for this song?
I would say that I'd give it about a 0.7.
0.7 is a good compromise. Mm-hmm. Giving the album a score of 1.6 out of 2 on track 2.
Way to go, Passion Pit. All right, so this next track off of the album is called Carried Away. Oh, I get carried away. Crotches in the frame, right? That's what I want. Just this.
This area. Now that's how you do a chorus.
Boom!
It harkens back to track one, but with a more upbeat style. In the second repeat of that second chorus, they pick it up, they escalate it with increased backup vocals and the increased xylophone in the back. They put a little bit more instrumentation under it. And I think that helps support the end of the song a lot.
It adds a little bit of extra oomph. Because if you just do it twice, it's just kind of like, cool, there it is a second time. We didn't know what else to write. We needed to be 20 seconds longer. That's one of the big problems I have with like build-up songs sometimes. Mm-hmm. Like a lot of Pink Floyd songs, you're just like, okay, God, really? We're doing this again? Once you get to it, you're just like, yes, this is amazing. Mm-hmm. But then while you're on the journey, you know, you're definitely just like, oh, are we there yet? A kid in the back of the seat. Is that what you did to your parents? You just smacked them around?
Yeah, it's a drive faster, Papa! Beat my ass.
I always wondered why your parents were afraid of you.
Just trying it really hurt.
Except for beating your parents.
How do you think this song was as track 3, and what does it mean for the album?
Well, it's definitely, you know, more dancey. It's disco-y, but it's not as, like, syncopated dance.
You think this is a leveling off of the intensity? To me, it's like they hit the peak and then they polished it.
I mean, my favorite is still the first song, Take a Walk. That's because I really love Taco Bell, so, you know.
What do you say?
I like the Doritos Locos, Four Locos Taco. It's my favorite. Point.
Yeah, ooh, I do too. Have you had one?
I just take a taco and I just pour Four Loco on it.
And Doritos.
And just crunch up Doritos, yeah. Even go to Taco Bell, I just do that in my house.
I just cover myself with more like a Dorito does. cry and shame cry. No, explain to me how Take a Walk is anything like Taco Bell.
No, because it was featured in that Taco Bell commercial, remember? It's basically like a bunch of like snapshots of the taco, like the Doritos Locos.
Taco.
What the fuck is it called? It's like a taco, but instead of the The shell, it's a Dorito. It sounds amazing.
Oh, it is amazing. It doesn't sound anything.
Have you ever heard somebody eat it?
Why?
Have you ever heard a taco's feeling?
Have you ever heard a wolf cry to the full?
Was that Pocahontas?
Yeah, it was a Pocahontas reference.
Colors of the wind.
That's like an opera vibrato. It's like a wind. All right, what would you give song 3 for a rating, Dane?
I would give it a 0.9 again.
0.9?
Yeah.
I was going to say 0.8. I think 0.9 is fair. I mean, it's a great track.
It's definitely my second favorite track out of 3 tracks.
2.9s and a 0.7. That's 2.5 so far out of 3.
That's true. That is some stellar math skills, too. I was like, all those numbers add up to things. This next song off of Passion Pit's album is called Constant Conversation. Can tell by look, by the slightest crook in the neck or the blink of an eye. Well, then they'll see what they say and they'll do what they do, but it doesn't mean a goddamn thing. You can listen if you want, you can listen if you don't. Yeah, they'll talk, yeah, they'll even sing. Everybody now. Oh, 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 oh. They come singing through the window, singing. Singing through the bright spring leaves, everybody now. Oh, 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 oh. Yeah, they love you and they need you, but someday you're gonna need to find some other kind of place to go.
I got the camera. Dude, I got a boner. You know what I mean? A cloth boner?
Yeah, a cloth boner. Cloth boners. They're a problem. We must stop them. Donate down below. But yeah, I think that this one definitely was a change of pace. If they were kind of polishing the plateau, suddenly they hit the Mesa point.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, that was like Mesa Verde right there. I understand the direction. I like a band who accepts a challenge and goes out on a limb and...
I'm still thinking about it.
But it's definitely weird.
I thought that the background vocals... if they were trying to go the R&B route, they could have, like,
yeah.
You know you say, you know you say, you know you say.
They needed a black guy and not Squirrel Woman.
You never leave.
She did come back, and instead of just having little blurbs in the middle of a syncopated, like, breakdown, she had her little solo there, where she's saying something about believing or leaving or levying taxes. Lyrically, I think the song was a little bit disjointed from the sound. Like, the sound seriously sounded like R. Kelly was going to come out and lay some fucking lyric down about a sexosaurus in the jungle.
In this song, he's definitely drunk or high or something's wrong. I thought that it was like she was fed up with him drunk and getting drunk, so she's pouring out the drink.
They're in an argument.
She's
pouring out his drink. This takes a detour from the classic R&B, where it's not about freaking, it's about anti-freaking. Right?
I think it's actually a cool... concept that they're going with, you know, like the lyrics are such a juxtaposition to how the music sounds. They are definitely a detour from what an R&B song, you know, usually, you know, it's just always like, girl, man, your booty been shaking and you've been taking my breath away, and like, I'll be licking you up with my tongue and parts of me that are long and cloth boners. Cloth boners. What about instrumentation? Eric, go.
Laying off the synth a little bit. Going with a classic R&B, slow jam drums and bass. But the bass is walking around. Boom. Doo-doom. Boom. So there's almost always background vocals. There's either oohs or ahs or someone singing little things.
And I did like the chorus. The part goes like, oh, 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 oh. Even though there's no lyrics there, you know. Yeah. You know, I felt that their use of the O's there actually helped the song, as opposed to, you know, songs like whoa, 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 whoa.
You're like, all right, it's enough.
There's one word. Sorry, I threw up a little bit. I like it. Put that in. I'm a lyrical wordsmith genius. I just throw up and it turns into gold. But Beyonce had the best video ever.
Where are you taking us, Passion Pit? We want to know. Where's the train conductor?
We have no idea now. We've jumped tracks. We've changed turnstiles. We've jumped ship. Other
metaphors. I'm not willing to go less than 0.6.
I'd say 0.7 at least for me. We'll go with 0.6 to compromise.
Okay. Because
you have to be the boss, whatever.
So now we are 3.1 out of 4.